Mark to take us in. It's very exciting. So, allowing yourself to settle back into the chair, allowing yourself to feel your feet underneath you, your back up against the chair. And taking a moment and bring your awareness into the lower abdomen as you breathe in and breathe out. And staying in command of your mind. So if your mind wants to take off, you're going to tether it back. And you're going to say, no, this is my time to just be anchored deeply rooted within myself. It's a time for the mind to come to rest deep in your being. And allowing your mind to feel that rest. Down in the lower abdomen, about an inch and a half below the belly button, there's a place called the hara or the dantian. And so allow your mind to kind of poke around a little bit. To see where you're drawn in that area and see if you can keep your mind anchored there as you breathe in and breathe out. And taking a moment and set a kind orientation to yourself. Allow yourself to take a moment and be your own best friend. Allowing yourself to have a sweet orientation. Taking a moment and honoring all of the challenges that you manage. Taking a moment to honor the struggles you've been through. Take a moment and allow yourself to feel some appreciation for the journey that you've been on. And as you do that, you may feel your shoulders drop. You may feel your elbows and wrists and hands go heavy. You may find yourself relaxing the muscles in your hips and thighs and knees and calves. As you allow your mind to come to rest deep within yourself. I often say that when we surrender the body, it's like surrendering to God. I one time saw a healer, and the way he moved was so fascinating to me, and it struck me why. Because he had absolutely no tension in his body. He knew as a healer, he could wave his hand and plants would grow. God would come through him. So he carried no tension in his body. So allowing ourselves to release the tension in our feet, allowing ourselves to feel the ground underneath us, gravity pulling us towards the earth. Moving your awareness up through the ankles and through the lower legs. Lovingly and kindly moving your awareness around the body. And allowing yourself to let go and feel the field around the body. Around the lower legs and feet, around your knees. Lovingly and sweetly moving your awareness through your thighs, your hips, lower belly, mid-torso, front and back, your chest. Be loving, be kind, be sweet, be present. In the upper chest, the upper back, becoming aware of your left shoulder and then your right. Moving your awareness to the back of the neck, sides of the neck and front. Relaxing your jaw, cheeks, eyes, temples, forehead, above the ears, and the top of the head. And allow a loving, sweet presence, your awareness. What's really happening here is we're becoming aware of the love that's around us. It's always there, we just filter it out. Science has been saying that our neocortex actually filters out the primordial field. It's filtering out what's around us. So can we allow ourselves to widen our perceptual field and allow ourselves to feel things that we may not ordinarily allow ourselves to feel around us? And learning to trust that what we feel is real. There's actually something here. You're sensing something. It's real. So becoming aware of the space around you, and what if you could feel a sweetness around you, a love? What if you could allow your body to feel nourished from this love? What if your legs could pray in this love? What if it could be that love? What would it feel like? To feel transparent to the divine. And garnering the courage to be able to feel so deeply. And honoring that. What if your torso, you could feel the loving intelligence that's keeping you alive in all your organs right now? What if you could feel that life force going through you? Feeling love. How does it feel? Can you make your body transparent to what you would feel as love? Moving your awareness up to the neck, eyes, and head, and relaxing the space, kind of the muscles of the head and the skull, so that you can allow your relaxing, your thinking to relax as well. And be sweet. And be spacious. Allow yourself to sink into a knowing that you already know. You just often just walk. And now becoming aware of the love above the head. What if you could feel the love to the right of you? The love to the left. To the front. And to the back. Remembering the toroidal field of the energy field and allowing yourself to own that electromagnetic field around you. And an increase in awareness means an increase in consciousness. So knowing that awareness is consciousness. It's like Deepak Chopra says, mindfulness is the worst thing to call because his mind is not involved. It's about awareness. So just becoming aware of what you're aware of. Noticing that wherever the mind moves, your awareness moves, there's an impact. So scanning your field, allowing yourself to feel as symmetrical as possible in this field, but you may be drawn to certain areas and you kind of feel like, well, maybe it feels a little concave there, or it feels a little depleted. Set your awareness into that portion of your field and allow yourself to shape it with your awareness. Embody it. Start getting used to this grander version of yourself. Start getting used to the fact that heaven is here. We're just becoming aware of it. trusting any intuitions that come up as far as how to do this. Your intuition will suggest for you. You could be working with light or colors or shapes, but you'll know it because when you work with it, you can feel the impact of it, the thoughts, and how they work. And now moving your awareness to the space above the head, maybe about a foot and a half above the head, there's what they call the individuation point. It's where we individuate from the infinite. So think of it as maybe a drop of water from the ocean. So it's where you become a drop of water off the ocean. So poke your awareness up above the head somewhere and trust your instinct as far as where you're drawn. And gently, with a sweet intention, move through that and see if you can kind of get to the other side and feel the ocean on the other side. And any sensations you have, trust. And see if you can magnify it and amplify it. You may feel something cascade over your head and down over the shoulders, down through the body, moving down through you. And allow yourself to just be with that for a little bit. We're training in our ability to sense. This field of intelligence that surrounds us at all times. And offers great wisdom and well-being. So now bring to mind something that's scary for you, whatever is making you raw right now, whatever is your challenge in life. Scan your body head to toe and see, where does your field contract and pull in? And with that same gentle, loving presence, move towards it, move into the area. Knowing that this contraction, all it does is pull you away from source. So what if you were to move your conscious awareness into that spot and take a stand? What if you were to be able to hold the challenge with great dignity? If you could fall into love in that space. And it can sometimes feel like it takes great courage because we're so used to clutching and pulling there and our identity is so wrapped to that. So the idea of being able to move into it and saying, I'm going to have the courage to let this go. I want to feel who I am, my eternal nature. I want to feel my essence, and this is the small me, and this is so not going to serve, it's so not working for me. I'm going to surrender that over and move it out of my field so that I can feel the peace of the eternal. And take a stand and claim it. Honor it all. What would it be like if the next time you thought of that thought, you took a stand and you said, now I'm gonna remember who I am here. So allow that divine love to move in and through it and around it. And just say, I want this space back. I want to be able to inhabit this space again. I want to expand. And whatever is challenging, allowing yourself to feel kind of the bigness of who you really are with whatever this challenge is. and feel how good it feels to hold your own, to hold that space of love. And I'll be back for you in a few moments. Hold it. Breathing a little deeper and feeling your field expand a bit. Airing it out. You see, spirit can't take it from us until we let it go. We keep clutching like that, it'll never get cleansed. Aerating out our consciousness. And allowing ourselves to feel the spaciousness of spirit. And picking one other thing that may be challenging to you, scan your body head to toe, see where is it? Where do you pull in? Where do we clutch, grip, and grasp? And allow your mind to move into that area and stretch it out, expand. Remember who you really are. How good it feels. And as the area opens, allow the spaciousness to move around a little bit so you can kind of aerate the other areas around it. And taking a moment now to feel how you felt in the beginning and how you're feeling now. And knowing that if every day we train, every day we train, surrendering the body over, surrendering the body over, surrendering the body over, that there is a gift at the end, and that is that we get to feel sublime states. And start realizing that there's another whole game we can be playing. And feeling the freedom of that. With us and seeing about how would the rest of your day go. If you go through the day and you find yourself contracting, but you say, no, I'm going to let go, I'm going to expand, I'm going to expand, I'm going to expand. And seeing yourself go through the rest of the day and the different choices you'd make from an expansive state than you would from a contracted state. Seeing yourself going to sleep at night with this intention of surrendering to the infinite. Tomorrow morning when you wake up, what if you just linger in that state for a little bit before your feet hit the floor and stay there for a bit? So bringing this awareness back with you. Still feeling very expanded, very open. And as you allow your eyes to open, allow the room to come to you, staying anchored inside of yourself and allowing the room to come to you. and not allowing yourself to go in your regular muscular armoring. What would it be like to stay deep in that restful self?
Ground yourself back into this body.